send a chase in a way. Got a neighbor spots where they don't take time. Might pull up on a hop if it's up too hot. And you wanna play ball, hit a 3-point shot. Boy, this my court, got a block on lock. I made it by the million and I'm only 19. Icy water dripping on a white tee. And shorty got a man, but she saying wife me. I got chest coming in like a pair of Nikes. If I like it, then you know I'm finna get it. Just do it. Hit the bag and then I flip it. Watch me do it. Just do it. All them all on my wrist going stupid. Just do it. Tryna put them on, but they never do it. They're like, hold up, wait a minute. Like, don't make sense to really get it. I'm steady getting to the chicken. That tasty finger licking chicken. I mean, I'm getting to the good guap. Keep it racking my socks. Diamonds cost me a lot. Nike check up all of my socks. Hey. Hey, yo. Nike check.
They don't know my name. I get through the pain. Taste sweet on my face like it's lemonade. Tie me up in chains. I get through the pain. Taste sweet on my face like it's lemonade.
They say falling and let go. But I know I got an antidote to retain some kind of self-control. Look inside my head through a telescope. You erased all the calls from a telephone. No sense of smell, maybe tell a joke. Holding back your tears, singing minimal syllables. Yeah, look at me.
EA Sports coverage of the National Football League brings us to Western Pennsylvania and Heinz Field in the Steel City of Pittsburgh. They love the black and gold here in the Steel City. And a few moments ago, their Steelers emerged from the Heinz Field tunnel. They're set, we're set, as the Steelers are ready to do battle with the Houston Texans. The final weekend of the summer. Hope you're enjoying it wherever you are as we are off and running on EA Sports. Takes this about 5 yards deep. And no run back here, so they'll bring it out to the 25. First carry of the ball game, and he'll be upended at the 28-yard line. Just a 3-yard gain there.
Well, that's just a pile of bodies there, and that's when you kind of find out who's a tough guy, right? Who can stand up and make a play? It was only a 3-yard run, but for both sides, they had to walk away from that feeling like, okay, I can stand up when the going gets tough in here.
Here's 2nd and 7 now from the 28. On the give, this is McFarland. And he'll get about 3 here as he's out to the 30.
The ball carrier. Zach Cunningham on the tackle. That's a gain of 3. Now 3rd and 5.
Third play here, this opening drive, as they're up against a 3rd and 5. From the gun, it's Roethlisberger. Ebron caught left side. And he's going to have the first down, yardage to the 35.
We're up Pittsburgh.
Third down turns to first with that 5-yard pickup. Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on 1st and 10. From the shotgun, it's Roethlisberger. This is Chase Claypool on the receiving end. And he'll be tackled right on the chalk of the 45. They picked up 5 yards last time. Now they double it and get 10 here.
45-yard line.
So after 2 first downs, they get another here. 1st and 10 at the 45. On on the handoff, it's McFarland. And down he goes at the 49, a three-yard pickup. 3 yards on that last carry. Here's second and seven.
3 yard pickup brings up second and seven.
And he's going to be taken down with a marker on the field. So let's see about the call. So a decent gain, but all for naught on the penalty.
That's too bad, isn't it? They were feeling pretty good about it. The only people celebrating, the guys who just gave up that play.
On second down, McFarland. He'll get three up to midfield.
Some of the most unselfish players on any football team, defensive tackles, because we ask them to just eat up blocks, allow other people to make tackles. But when he can make a play himself, as we just saw there, that's a big day.
The Texans here on third down, putting an extra defender in the secondary. From midfield now, here's Roethlisberger. And the throw there going to be incomplete.
Normally you think the tight end's going to be able to catch the football and handle that contact, but in this case, maybe a little too much target to hit. That one was timed well. Incomplete.
Only two punts for him last week in the loss as he gets this one away. And that one hits a little too close to the goal line, and it continues into the end zone for a touchback. Watson will bring up the Texans here, first and 10 at the 20. The first carry now, this is Johnson. And he's going to get seven out of this before being taken down at the 27.
Johnson, the ball.
That's a really nice job by them picking up the run blitz and detecting it and blocking it and turning it into a nice run. And a lot of times you think if you blitz a running play, you're going to smother it. But a lot of the blitzers, they come in a little bit high. They don't have great leverage, and they're easily blocked and turned to the side.
A good run, got seven on first. Here's second and three. This is David Johnson, the former All-Pro. And oh, his first carry, he loses the football. And it looks like Steeler football. It is. That's probably bringing back nightmares of last week, isn't it?
No doubt about it. Right now, I'm looking over at the coaching staff, and I'm seeing the wheels turning in their heads. And you know what is happening? They're remembering how they started the season in camp, even in the offseason where they emphasized ball security, and they're wondering why the message isn't sinking in.
Yeah, five turnovers last week, now one here in the opening quarter. That is caught inside the five. And out of bounds, all the way down at the three. A good pick up there, 22. Right after the turnover, they come out throwing.
And that means it's a sudden change situation. We used to practice it on defense. Sudden change, get out there, stop the offense. But you typically run out there a little bit unsettled. I think that's why he came right out throwing the football, hoping to catch him off balance.
And he did. And he'll be stopped about a yard shy of the goal line after a pickup of about three.
Short of the goal line.
Second and goal from the one. Tossing this out wide to McFarland. And he'll actually lose a little bit of yardage here. Back to the two.
Gary, you can almost feel him thinking as he's running the football. Just one more block, anything to get me to the perimeter and around the corner. Couldn't quite get there. Ends up getting spilled for a loss.
They'll come out in the pistol. Now they'd really like to make the short field pay off. We'll see if they can, but this is third and goal.
Alert.
They'll run with McFarland. And he's in. Touchdown, Pittsburgh. Anthony McFarland. his third touchdown now on the year. And the Steelers have taken a first quarter lead. Chris Boswell now for the extra point. Through to make it 7-0 Steelers.
Makes the score Steelers 7, Texans nothing. Chris Boswell to kick off for Pittsburgh.
Boswell now to kick it away after the touchdown. Taken in the end zone. And he'll just take a seat and the drive will begin at the 25-yard line.
At their own 25-yard line.
The Texans offense ready to go here for their next drive. And they had the fumble last time that led to a touchdown. That's a no-no. We'll see what they do here this go-around.
A big no-no. Put that in capital letters. Turning it over. The other team takes it down and scores. That could be a deflator for a football.
And the Steeler pressured too much here. He's going down. Bud Dupree. The blitz works to perfection as he gets in there to dump him for a loss of 8. Gotta imagine the pass rush will be equally intense here on second down following the sack. It's 2nd and 18. Out of the gun, Watson. And he hits his target. It's Kenny Stills. And way up past the 35 before he's taken down. A gain there of 21 yards.
And the Texans first down.
Line of scrimmage, the 37 on 1st and 10. Running from the gun, Johnson. And this will be stopped at the 44. That one good for 7 yards.
Johnson, the ball carrier. Minka Fitzpatrick on the tackle. It's a gain of 7. Brings up 2nd and 3 at the 44-yard line.
On 2nd down now. It's Johnson. And this time not as successful as he'll get back to the line of scrimmage and no more.
The line of scrimmage. No gain on the play. And it's 3rd down.
After 1, 7-0 on EA Sports.
Steelers 7, Texans nothing.
Watson on 3rd down. And that's complete to Cooks. And he's able to get this one out closer to midfield across the 45. It'll be a 3-yard gain, and that'll bring up 4th down. And in their own territory, needing only a few inches, they're going to line up to go for this thing on 4th down. And now on the pitch, the ball's loose. Boy, a curious decision to go for it doesn't pan out. And the Steelers, they're going to take over an excellent field position. And 10, it's Roethlisberger. Now they set up a screen for McFarland. No gain on the screen there. It's 2nd down. Here's 2nd and 10.
No gain on the play. Brings up 2nd and 10 at the Texans' 44-yard line.
Off the play fake. Here's Roethlisberger sliding out of the pocket. That's complete. It's Anthony McFarland. And he'll go down shy of the 40 at the 41. Call it a gain of three. And just like that, it's third down. Out of the gun, it's Roethlisberger. Looking for Johnson, and it's intercepted. Picked off by the corner, Bradley Roby. And they will finally get him down as he's all the way to the 36-yard line.
Intercepted by the Texans.
Ah, Brandon, this is a veteran quarterback back there. He should know better than to make a throw like this. This is definitely not his best ball, and I think he knew this was trouble the second it was leaving his hand.
So from the 36 now, first and 10. After the interception, here's Watson. They'll roll him out right. Under pressure, and he will go down. Sack back at the 38. Terrell Edmonds comes flying in from safety for the sack.
Second down.
Second and 11. A shotgun snap for Watson. It's complete. Stills. And this will go as a gain of seven as he gets it to the 30-yard line.
Kenny Stills.
I always laugh when people say, what's the toughest route to defend? And I'm like, any of them, especially if it's a good receiver. That makes things very difficult. But when you're running a drag route, something short, shallow, going through defenders, using guys almost as screens in order to get open, that makes things tougher, guys trying to get to the football.
Targeting and finding Stills once more. Third catch of this first half for him, and this one is a first down.
First down, Texans.
On first down, it's Watson. And Stills bringing it in. They'll get him to the ground at the 20 following a pickup of four.
One thing you're hoping for when you run drag routes, you're able to hit a receiver in stride and he can pick up a lot of yardage after the catch. But in this situation, the defense was effective, able to stop him before he could get a good head of steam going.
4 yards on that last completion, so that sets up second and six. From the gun, a run for Johnson. 3 yards on the pickup. That's going to set up an interesting third and about four to go.
Brandon, all things considered, they have to feel pretty good about getting that type of a gain considering the blitz that they just had against them.
Gun on third, Watson. And that is incomplete. Oh, he had a defender right there with him to force that to the ground. And fourth down now coming up.
It's fourth down.
So on fourth down, Texan kicker Kyme Fairbairn comes on. This will be a 34-yard attempt. The kick by Fairbairn is good. And they are on the board, but still trailing. It's 7-3. Well, that's something of a pick-me-up. The offense certainly has struggled, but they do get the field goal before half to put three on the board.
Yeah, you don't want to be shut out, but let's face it. Those 3 points, that's not going to solve all their problems either.
So not much time to speak of remaining in this first half as the kick's away. And no return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken.
The Steelers take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
The Steeler offense here about ready for their next drive. And following the interception, we'll see what they can put together on this drive.
I hear my old college coach right now. He always used to tell us before every game, the team making the fewest mistakes will win. What they're hoping is that last mistake is their only one of the game.
Coaches, that's all they talk about, turnovers, right?
Minimizing those and maximizing opportunities.
And looked like some movement there. Let's get the call. And that'll be accepted, of course, and that moves him back five. And that false start penalty certainly not helping their cause here. Second down and long. Here's Roethlisberger. Able to hit his target, Claypool. And they'll take him down at the 31-yard line. That's a gain of 11. Would have been a first down if not for that penalty moments ago. 2 minutes to play in this first half. 7-3, our score. Once we hit halftime, as we do all season, we'll send it down to Jonathan Coachman in Orlando. He'll have all the stats and scores from games in progress around the NFL.
The best multitasker.
Now Ben hit, and he lost the football. It's loose. And the Texans say they have it. They do. Holding on to the football becoming a little bit of an issue. He had two fumbles last week, remember?
I played for a guy that used to talk all the time about creating turbulence in the pocket, making the quarterback jumpy, make him antsy, keep getting after him a little bit, and make sure he thinks about holding on to the ball because you're going after him.
Now the Steelers use the first of their three timeouts. It's just their first, so they'll have two remaining here before we get to halftime. So now they have to contend with second and 13 after the first down run goes backwards. Now it's Watson. Screenplay, Johnson. He's to the 10, and he is out of bounds, but first he gets it inside the 10 to the 7. A nice pickup of 14, and it moves the stick, sets up a first and goal. So it's first and goal, and a great opportunity to get that lead back before the break. From the gun, here's Watson. Forced out to... And this results in six. Touchdown! Deshaun Watson, his third touchdown now on the year. And the Texans have taken the lead. So a quarterback scramble, certainly a pass play, but he saw something, tucked it, and got in the end zone.
A lot of quarterbacks, when they scramble, they're scrambling to create more time to throw the ball downfield. In this situation, as you noted, he tucked it and took off. Great play by him.
Fielded in the end zone. And he'll decide to not bring this one out as their drive will begin at the 25.
25-yard line.
The Pittsburgh offense at the line to start their next drive. And last time, not only the turnover, but that turned into 6 points. They got to make up for that here.
We always hear about empty possessions, but some are worse than others. You can have an empty possession, punt the ball away, get yourself set to play defense, but when you turn it over, it changes momentum, and when they take it downfield and punch it in on you, that's a bad possession all the way around.
Yeah, but you're hungry to get back out there, aren't you?
You better be, because otherwise, it's going to be a long day for you.
Give him 10 yards on the pickup, and that'll bring up a second and just about a few inches here. Options galore here, second and a few inches.
The 49-yard line.
To throw here, Roethlisberger. Short little throw to Ebron, and he'll take it down shy of the 45 at the 46.
That's good.
Now the Steelers use the second of their three timeouts as they get the stoppage with just under 50 seconds remaining in half number one. They'll throw on first down with Roethlisberger. And that's going to be incomplete. Too tough to hold on to that one. It's second down.
It's another zone defense. It looks like it's open for possibilities, but they did a nice job patrolling the middle of the field and forcing an incompletion.
An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a second and 10. Throwing again, it's Roethlisberger. That ball caught by the former Toledo Rocket, Deontay Johnson. And he's in. Touchdown, Steelers. Deontay Johnson, his first touchdown here of the new campaign. And the Steelers are going to retake the lead. And that makes it 14-10.
Good. Makes the score Steelers 14.
So not much time to speak of remaining in this first half as the kick's away. This taken in about 4 yards deep. And he'll be brought down shy of the 20, so the decision to bring it out of the end zone, not a good one.
The Texans take over first and 10 at their own 18-yard line.
The Texans offense ready to go here for their next drive. Inside of a minute left in the half, does the fact that you're down on the scoreboard influence what you do or, I guess, don't do on this final drive?
It certainly does, but what influences me even more is who I've got running my football team out on the field and the weapons around him. Can he make a play? Can he get into someone that we're going to trust to take care of the ball? If that's the case, I might push it a little bit here and try and get something before the half runs out.
4 yards remain for second down. Off of play action, it's Watson. Going deep here for Stills. And this is what here? Incomplete, they say. Looked like it was intercepted, but he apparently did not get the 2 feet down in bounds.
And 4 yards to go.
Now they face a third down and 4 after that incompletion on second down. From the gun, Watson. Now he's flushed out left. And that is incomplete. Down to 15 seconds now.
For Randall Cobb. Incomplete.
On fourth down, here's Brian Anger now to kick this one away.
For the Texans.
He punted 4 times in the loss last week as he gets this one away here. And this kick will be touched down as they spot it inside the 45-yard line.
At their own 44-yard line.
The Steeler offense here about ready for their next drive. And from this spot in the field with the clock where it's at, you think we're just going to see a knee and that's it?
And I think in this situation, that's the proper play. But we do know there's some risk takers out there that may want to take one more shot before the clock runs out.
Out of bounds at the 47-yard line. It's a gain of 9. Brings up 2nd and 1 yard.
They'll come up now on 2nd and 1 yard. On the ground, it's McFarland. And he is tackled inside the 40, not quite to the 35. So we've reached halftime here in a 4-point game. As we'll send you down to Orlando, we check in with Jonathan Coachman for our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach, the Texans down on the scoreboard, but they do get the first crack here as we are back underway in the second half. Taken in the end zone. And he'll be dropped at the 21-yard line. So bringing it out of the end zone proves not a good decision. Loses him about 4 yards.
At their own 21-yard line.
The Texans offense ready to go here for their next drive. They're down here, but very much in this game. What's the tonality of a coach's talk when a game is within striking distance like this at intermission?
Typically, what they're doing is emphasizing the things that went well in the first half and wanting more of that. Sure, you've got to go over some of the errors and clean up some things because there's a reason you're down. But overall, I think they want to stay positive, stay up with this team. We're just starting the second half, and we've got the football. So go ahead and punch it in, and then we'll take it from there.
See how that recipe works. 11 yards there, first down.
They ran that one well, and not only did they pick up a nice chunk of yardage on the screen, they sent a message to the defense. Rush the passer all you want, but you better be careful. We can hit you going back the other direction.
Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10. And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled. 11 yards there, just like last play.
Running lanes were at a premium in the first half, but he's able to find some room there, and he's hoping that that's a precursor of a big second half.
Now a first down throw, Watson. He gets it to Cooks. And down he goes at the 49, a three-yard pickup.
Well, if you do read man coverage, Brandon, the drag route's a pretty good one to run against it because you're running away from people on it.
That first down completion only netted him three. Second and 7. From the gun, Watson. Flush to his right. He'll try and run it. He'll end up getting 5 out of that, but now they're looking at third down.
How about a tip of the cap to the defense? They're working against a very mobile quarterback, but all day long they've kept him under wraps. And on that play, they held him to a short gain.
Third and 2, Watson. This is Johnson, he's got it. And he's got the first down yardage before he's brought down at the 42.
4 yards.
It's a gain of 4 there, and it gives him a new set of downs. It's a 6-yard pickup, but it gets him to 2nd and 4.
He had a ton of success here so far, but you get the feeling that he might be on the verge of popping one.
Yeah, even on that one, there was a little bit of a hole, but it closed there quickly at the end. From the 36, Watson. He'll try and set up the screen. It's complete. And he doesn't quite make it, taking it within an eyelash. Dropped at the 1. It's a gain of 35.
Oh, I think we all understand his disappointment. Didn't quite get to the end zone, and you know it's just got to be tough to see a yard line underneath you after a play like that. Still, all in all, a huge play, and now they're set up 1st and goal at the 1.
And he's in for the score. Touchdown, Texans. Deshaun Watson with his 2nd touchdown of the game, 4th of the year. And the Texans have once again taken the lead. And this is no good. It's a missed extra point. Boy, in a tight game, how important might that turn out to be here as the second half rolls along? So with the missed PAT in his rearview mirror, he goes back out to kick this one off. And this one will not be handled. It's into the end zone for a touchback.
25-yard line.
The Pittsburgh offense at the line to start their next drive. They trail offense, first time to touch the ball in quarter 3, and we'll see what they can do.
And I can't wait to see what they have planned, because some teams script to start a half.
Under pressure, and the Texans able to get in there for the sack. J.J. Watt that time able to do what he does best, and that's sack the quarterback. So the opening drive of this 3rd quarter, they're trying to set the tone for the second half.
And without a doubt, they did exactly that. I've known coaches who have said the first 5 minutes of each half are so important to do exactly what you said, which is set the tone. I've also heard coaches talk about the first 5 plays. Let's go out and be aggressive right off the top. That's exactly what they did.
back him up five. Now with the play clock about to expire, we get a whistle and a timeout. It's just their first, so two remaining as they burn one here in this third quarter. And boy, again, they won't get this off in time. And that'll set them back five.
Kick it and go. never a cap, out of the draft, watching me bow, soon as I snap, hit it a pack, wipe for the sack, shaking a mile, breaking